hey, welcome to this SJPL Sprouts video. You want to hear a knock-knock joke? No, it's important. It ties into the video. Okay, you'll play along? Good. Here's what we're going to do. I'm going to say knock-knock. You say who's there. You know how a knock-knock joke works. But this is a video, so I'm going to have to just trust that you're doing it. Now, this is an old knock-knock joke, but it is one of my favorites, so maybe you've heard it or you've heard a variation of it. It goes like this. Ready? You ready to play along? Okay, it goes like this. Knock-knock. Interrupting chicken. Mark! That's the joke. That's a pretty good joke, right? Well, the reason I told you that joke is because today, the book I want to tell you about is really silly. It is called Interrupting Chicken, and it is by David Ezra Stein. This is so much fun. One of my favorite things about being a dad was when I would read to my kids before bed. And hopefully, you get books read to you before bed too, or you read books to your kids before bed. Well, it was one of my favorite activities, and in this book, well, Little Red Chicken's dad is trying to put Little Red Chicken down for bed for the night and is trying to read a story, but the problem is Little Red Chicken keeps interrupting the story. So every time he starts a new fairy tale, he doesn't get very far before Chicken interrupts. And it basically chaos ensues, and it's a lot of fun. I think you'll like this book. It's also a great way to introduce your kids to some fairy tales that maybe they've never heard before. So check out Interrupting Chicken by David Ezra Stein. I really love Interrupting Chicken. And so for this craft today, I thought I would teach you how to make a chicken in a cup. It makes a chicken noise. Now, sometimes you'll see this called a frog in a cup. But I always heard it called a chicken in a cup for the longest time. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to make a chicken in a cup.
The first thing we are going to need to make our chicken in a cup is some yarn. Now, this is just standard, cheap old yarn. Whatever you have on hand will work perfectly. Next, we'll need some scissors to cut the yarn and to poke a hole in our third object, which is a plastic cup. The last thing we need is a little bit of water, and I just put some water in another cup I happen to have handy. Our first step is where grown-ups' help is going to be necessary, because right in the bottom of the empty cup, we are going to poke a hole with our scissors. Make sure it's the empty cup, because if you do the cup with water, water will get everywhere. Then, next, we need to pull out about 1.5 to 2 feet of our yarn, and then take our scissors and cut that off. The third step is kind of tricky and by far the hardest part about making a chicken in a cup, and that is you have to thread your yarn into the hole you just poked in your first plastic cup. Now, what I found to be easier is to take your scissors and use the end of your scissors to push the yarn through the hole like this. Now, if you're really good at sewing, you're probably laughing at me right now, and that's okay. I have been laughed at for way worse than poking yarn through a hole with a pair of scissors. Next thing we're going to do is we are going to pull that yarn through, but before we do that, we have to do something very important, and that is go to the other end of the yarn, and we are going to tie a knot. In fact, tie 2 or 3 knots, make a nice big knot so that when it's through and we go to pull it through the cup, it doesn't pull all the way through our empty hole. So when we pull it through like this, ta-da, it stays.
So now that you have your cup with your yarn going through, you can make the sound of a chicken. But here's the thing, you do it by running your fingers down the yarn, but if you can hear, it doesn't really sound like a chicken. That's because there's not enough tension on our fingers, enough friction. So what we can do to fix that is, if you remember, I said you would also need some water. So I have a cup with water and I'm gonna get my fingers wet. That water is cold. And then now that my fingers are wet, I'm gonna take the cup and I'm gonna put my fingers on there like this. And if I run it down, it makes a sound like that. And I'm kind of doing it in a jerky fashion. And that's what you do. You can do this to make a chicken in a cup, and it's really fun. And you can do long noises. You can do short ones like I did. And you can work on making your own fun chicken sounds. So I hope you had fun making a chicken in a cup, and I will see you next time. Now, in each one of these SJPL Sprouts videos, we're going to give you a tip that you can use to grow your child into becoming a lifelong reader. Now, it's nothing too heavy and too preachy and too wordy, just simple things that you can do with your child to help them nurture a love of books and reading. When I was discussing interrupting chicken earlier in this video, I mentioned how that storybook might be a great way to introduce your child to some classic fairy tales. And you might have thought to yourself, well, what kid doesn't know about fairy tales? And to be perfectly honest, probably quite a few. One thing that I discovered when I worked at the library was that if it wasn't featured in the movie Shrek, a lot of kids didn't know about that particular fairy tale. And there's a reason, I think, behind that, and that is the fact that the publishing industry has put out so many great children's books over the years that nursery rhymes and fairy tales have kind of just been pushed to the back burner. Now, sometimes we'll get rehashings of the stories, but the kids don't realize that it's a rehashed version of a classic. So something I would encourage you to do is to maybe check out a book of Mother Goose nursery rhymes or check out some classic fairy tale books. And don't worry, I know some of the original versions are pretty grim, pun intended, but there are some great, very child-friendly versions of classic fairy tales that you can find to share with your child. And it's a great way to sit down and share something that maybe you loved as a child with your child now. And of course, that is going to help you grow a lifelong reader.